Mr. Speaker, his answer to a question as to what he would indicate what would be a measure of his success as special prosecutor was not was him stating that his success shouldn't be measured in terms of the number of people that he imprisoned, but by the integrity that he brought to the office, and by prosecuting or undertaking his work without fear, favor, malice, ill will, and that he wanted to create an institution that would work to fight corruption and put in place mechanisms which would deter people who would otherwise have engaged in those corrupt acts. He was not interested in self-aggrandizement, but in what he could contribute to our efforts to eradicate corruption, particularly being minded of the president's insistence that we cannot continue to do business as usual, but we have to do something different and something positive and move this country in the direction where corruption would be a high-risk, low-profit undertaking, instead of being an undertaking in which people merely get slapped on the wrist and continue with actions which militated against the forward march of this country. In his response to a question on plea bargaining, Mr. President, and as I conclude, he explained that these provisions offered an avenue for accused persons to make reparations to the people of Ghana for the consideration of the special prosecutor and the courts. In his view, it would be better if the nation retrieved the monies which had wrongfully found its way into others' pockets than to send people to jail, and assure the committee that if approved, his office would act professionally and reasonably in dealing with offers for reparation. Mr. Speaker, as I conclude, I will urge all those who have butterflies in their tummies about the appointment of Mr. Martin Amido, including some who may have enjoyed double salaries as MPs and ministers, to take advantage of this provision and take steps to make reparation as indicated in the act. I thank you, Mr. Speaker.